from the infinite to the infinitesimal, from the center of the Earth to the edge of the cosmos. We can go back and forth in time and explore places we've never been. It's just a matter of imagination, and I have a lot of that.
Hi, I'm Dominic Monaghan, and I'm curious. Looking, yes, thank you, but I'm also curious about everything else. My love of science and nature is based on my own curiosity, and nothing excites me more than exploration. Check it out. Yep, that's our home, the Big Blue Marble. Gorgeous, right? The whole planet is around about 8,000 miles or just under 13,000 kilometers across. And if we could peer deeper inside, we'd find that it's layered. Our oceans and atmospheres, they're just a thin layer. Check it out. This is the deepest ocean. And look how thin the atmosphere is. Jetliners fly at their highest around about here. And the International Space Station, you may think it's in deep space, right? Well, look, here is its orbit. So all of life on Earth, all the life that we know of, exists in this tiny little layer, just a veneer on the planet. But let's look at it in a different way. And this is where I really love virtual reality. Check it out. If we collected all the water on Earth from all the rivers, the oceans, the lakes, everything, we could form a ball and we'd get a water drop 860 miles or 1,380 kilometers across. Our atmosphere adds up too. If we could collect all that air, we'd have a gas ball about 1,200 or 1,920 kilometers across. A little bit bigger. You want to see something really cool? If we could take every human on Earth, all 7+ billion of us, and put us together to make a people ball, that would be about 0.5 miles across. Look at that tiny little thing, that's us. Heck, if we could take all life on Earth, all the animals, all the insects, the plants, even the bacteria, and collect them into a ball, it would be only 8 miles or 12 kilometers across. Look. And that's life on Earth. That's all life on Earth. And it's puny. As thin as this veneer is, the biosphere, which includes us, is one of the most incredibly complex and diverse things ever known. But what really is it? Up until 2.5 billion years ago, Earth's oceans were loaded with iron and nickel, making them green in color. And the only life on the planet was bacteria that lived in these oceans. Now, this bacteria not only didn't need oxygen to survive, but oxygen was highly toxic to it, which was fine, since there was no oxygen in the oceans or the atmosphere. Then, an amazing thing happened. A more complex type of life called cyanobacteria evolved. They processed sunlight for energy and excreted oxygen. They breathed out so much oxygen that it reacted with the iron and the nickel in the water, and for the first time, Earth's oceans turned blue. Over 4 billion years, what began as molecules bumping into each other has become us, humans, and birds, and fish, viruses, and plants, and life, and insects. All of life, and all of us are interconnected in the chemistry of the atmosphere, the oceans, the soil. It's beautiful and infinitely complex. It's so self-organized and complex that some scientists actually consider the biosphere as a living entity. Think of how trillions of varied and specialized cells act on their own, but make up the human body. Well, here's a fun thought experiment for you. If there was a giant in space looking down on this super organism called Earth, what would he think of the wee humans all skittering around? Well, they sure do dig up and move around all manner of stuff. And they make certain things like machines and highways and cities. They're like ants Well, from this giant's perspective, some might think we humans are a bit like an aggressive bacteria, or possibly a highly successful fungus. Doesn't sound too nice, right? Or maybe we're more like the superorganism's neural cells, part of its brain, or part of its consciousness. After all, we've wired the planet with satellites, telecommunications, and the internet. Or maybe we're the black sheep of the planet, letting our waste like CO2 and other byproducts of our living build up to toxic levels, kind of like the cyanobacteria from 2.5 billion years ago. Our waste is transforming the biosphere. Or, and personally I like this one, as we plan to colonize other worlds, packing our spaceships with plants, bacterial cultures, animals, technology, and taking off into space, we're basically hoping one day to create another Earth-like home. An offspring. Earth Junior, if you will. So maybe what humans represent in this scenario is Earth's reproductive system. And if that's the case, that would make us the sperm, I guess, or maybe the egg. I don't know. But it's definitely incredible. And it sure is complex. And it makes me very curious.